14 and 16-inch MacBook Pro. Apple's new 14 and 16-inch MacBook Pro models, pre-order now, launching October 26. Apple in October 2021 overhauled the high-end MacBook Pro, introducing an entirely new design, new chips, new capabilities, and more. As Apple says, the revamped MacBook Pro models offer up extraordinary performance and the world's best notebook display. The 2021 MacBook Pro models come in 14.2-inch and 16.2-inch size options and they're equipped with mini LED displays, more ports, up to 64GB memory, and more powerful Apple Silicon chips, the M1 Pro and M1 Max. In short, they are the best MacBook Pro models to date. Apple's new MacBook Pro models can be configured with the M1 Pro chip or the M1 Max chip. Both chips feature a 10-core CPU with 8 high-performance cores and 2 high-efficiency cores, though there is a lower-end 8-core model available for the entry-level 14-inch MacBook Pro. There's also a 16-core neural engine in both chips. In short, they are the best MacBook Pro models to date. Apple's new MacBook Pro models can be configured with the M1 Pro chip or the M1 Max chip. Both chips feature a 10-core CPU with 8 high-performance cores and 2 high-efficiency cores, though there is a lower-end 8-core model available for the entry-level 14-inch MacBook Pro. There's also a 16-core neural engine in both chips. The difference between the Pro and Max designation comes down to GPU performance. The M1 Pro features a 16-core GPU, while the M1 Max features a 32-core GPU, with a 24-core GPU also available as a middle-tier upgrade option. The M1 Pro also supports up to 32GB unified memory, while the M1 Max supports up to 64GB unified memory. According to Apple, the CPU in the M1 Pro and Pro Max is up to 70% faster than the CPU in the M1. The GPU in the M1 Pro is up to 2x faster than the M1 and the GPU in the M1 Max is up to 4x faster than the M1. M1 Pro and Pro Max use a system-on-a-chip architecture like the M1, and the M1 Pro supports up to 200GB per second memory bandwidth and the M1 Pro supports up to 400GB per second memory bandwidth. The 14 and 16-inch MacBook Pro models feature a Liquid Retina XDR display, which is a mini LED display with up to 1000 nits sustained brightness, 1600 nits peak brightness, and a 1:000:000:1 contrast ratio. The 14-inch MacBook Pro has a resolution of 3024 by 1964 at 254 pixels per inch, and the 16-inch model has a resolution of 3456 by 2234 at 254 pixels per inch. There are slim 3.5mm bezels at the sides and the top, and the top of the display also features a notch design that houses a 1080p webcam. There are slim 3.5mm bezels at the sides and the top, and the top of the display also features a notch design that houses a 1080p webcam. Both displays come equipped with ProMotion technology, which supports. Both displays come equipped with ProMotion technology, which supports adaptive refresh rates ranging from 24Hz to 120Hz. Other display technologies include P3 Wide Color for true-to-life colors and True Tone, which shifts the white balance of the display to match the lighting in the room. Design-wise, the new MacBook Pro models look similar to the older models, but they are thicker and heavier with a more rounded design at the bottom corners. Silver and gray are the only available color options. There's an all-black keyboard that eliminates the touch bar, adding a full-sized row of function keys in its place. There's also a larger Touch ID button with a circular fingerprint sensor, with Touch ID used to unlock the Mac, authenticate purchases, and replace passwords. Below the keyboard, there's a large Force Touch trackpad. To accommodate the new M1 Pro and M1 Max chips, the MacBook Pro models have a re-architected thermal design that can move 50% more air than the prior generation version. The thermal design provides sustained performance while keeping the machine cool and quiet. Apple says the fans will not activate for most everyday tasks. Apple has reintroduced a number of ports that were previously removed from the MacBook Pro, and the new models offer an SDXC card slot, an HDMI 2.0 port, 3 USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports, 5mm headphone jack with support for high-impedance headphones, and a MagSafe 3 port that enables a new fast charging feature providing a 50% charge within 30 minutes. The 16-inch MacBook Pro uses a 140 watts power adapter, while the 14-inch models ship with either 67 watts or 96 watts power adapters depending on CPU configuration, and both machines can charge over either USB-C or MagSafe. There are 2x faster SSDs inside the new MacBook Pro models, which are configurable with up to 8 TB storage space. The M1 Pro chip supports 2 external displays with up to 6K resolution at 60Hz, while the M1 Max supports 3 external displays with up to 6K resolution and 1 external display with up to 4K resolution at 60Hz. Thanks to the new M1 Pro and M1 Max chips, the MacBook Pro models feature much improved battery life. The 14-inch MacBook Pro lasts for up to 17 hours when watching movies and up to 11 hours when browsing the web. The 16-inch MacBook Pro lasts for up to 21 hours when watching movies and 14 hours when browsing the web. Other features include Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5 support, plus there's a 6-speaker sound system with 2 tweeters, 4 force-canceling woofers and wide stereo sound. The 14-inch MacBook Pro is priced starting at $1,999, while the 16-inch MacBook Pro is priced starting at $2,499. How to buy the 14 and 16-inch MacBook Pro models can be ordered from Apple's online store or bought in.